17 years ago, a creative young man named Charles TRAHAN was working at a place known as the Mothership. The Mothership had a new project. Charles had the foresight to document this project. That project was ESPN News.
This is ESPN News.
ESPN News' first day was a proud time for the network. While other employees were partying, the people doing the grunt work for the new network labored into the night. PAs scrambled to get the highlights together for the network that never seemed to end. Editors used their skills to help put the highlights together. And when the highlight was done, the PAs literally had to run to the studio. Meanwhile, the graphics crew was busy on their computer. The prompters collated all the scripts. The technical staff took care of the video and audio. The director called the shots. The producers tried to maintain order of their show, and the coordinating producers oversaw the entire operation. As for the people in front of the camera, they had to relay news and information to the viewers. Most of the time since opening day, the network performed flawlessly. Other times, well, not so flawlessly.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to stumble!
From the worldwide leader in sports, this is ESPN News.
Just 2 days after Dennis Rodman gave photographer Eugene Amos a boot in the groin, the NBA has indeed kicked back. We will have the details coming up very shortly. Chuck.
Yeah, Pam kind of disappeared.
Coming up this half
mysteriously.
Hour.
Okay, so there you see Dave Revsine walking right behind me, and you see that...
Speaking of ties, that's the situation in the NL West when Sunday's play began. The Dodgers and Giants deadlocked. I'm heading south. Help me. Mark Schott.
Deck is Barry Larkin.
In attendance. I need a new chair.
All right, the New Orleans Saints would like to talk.
Hi. And today the QB re-signed with the club. He'll be the third stringer behind Cordell Stewart and Jim Miller after starting all but one game last year. That's Mike Greenberg. Hi, I'm Dave Revsine. Apparently Cowher never said anything about a good job. Did he there, Mike?
Not that I know of.
No. Mm-mm. Okay, tell you what, we're going to go over here now. What do you say? Huh? Why don't we go over here?
It's a little giddy.
Hello again, good people. Welcome to the network that never sleeps. This is the ESPN News Network. Side by side with Ian Page, I am Jason Jackson.
And coming up, the Bulls try to take a commanding lead on the Heat in Miami while Tiger Woods...
Well, thank you for hanging around on the ESPN News Network, your 24-hour source for sports news. She's Betsy Ross, and I'm Dave Revsine. And
yeah, it's not an earthquake,
something really,
really
funky is going
it's
on
okay.
over there. I
it's
thought maybe it's just some camera effect.
Well, maybe it is.
Yes.
Maybe it's like a new spin on this opening. Hello there, and welcome to the ESPN News Network. We are your 24-hour source for sports. Did that move just really quickly?
I felt like I was on a roller coaster.
That's what I thought, too.
Winning a race on the circuit, even more impressive. Martin did that yesterday, capturing the 200, part of the Busch Grand National Series. So heading into today, Martin had everything he could, had won everything he could. But what he would, he would without a doubt trade all of it for this weekend's big prize. Let's just show the highlight, for goodness sake.
He's got two doubles and three RBIs. Will we be back? I guess we're not going to be back. With interleague play, We are going to break, so we are going to go to break. We'll be back in a moment.
To an alcohol education program in hopes of having charges against her dropped. Well, stay with us, folks. We've got more to bring to you. ESPN News moves on. No, let's talk about Cheryl Miller, why don't we? We need to take a break. ESPN News returns in just a moment.
Microphone.
Yes, this is television where you need a microphone, that is for sure.
That's better.
We asked you to put your mic on real quick. Right there.
Oh, sorry.
Surprising announcements of the year in sports. Rich Kotite inherited a very bad New York Jets team and will leave behind an absolutely dreadful New York Jets team. The Jets, excuse me please. It helps to have a microphone. The Jets went from 6-10 in the final year of the Pete Carroll era to 3-13 last year and 1-14 this year, heading into the season finale with Miami on Sunday. That's better.
Well, you know that something is certainly wrong in the NBA when a team scores 64 points. Actually, we've missed my microphone here. What a boy.
Yes, this is television where you need a microphone, that is for sure. Well, that's exactly what happened last night. Let's go with the highlights between the Cavs and the Spurs, why don't we?
But we'll start you off in Atlanta, the Braves and the Dodgers and some pretty good pitchers.
Well, one day after facing...
Well, we have a problem here with the microphone. Okay, sorry, folks.
One day after facing Chan Hill Park, the Braves went up against the Dodgers' other Asian sensation, Hideo Nomo.
continue the, actually, I want you to talk about this one.
I'm going to talk about this one because it's my story. Continuing the always grip.
Euphoria subsides here. The Packers will turn their attention to their free agents, seven or eight of whom are starters. First and foremost, though, Green go.
All right, Bonnie cutting out a little early.
And welcome in. Hello and welcome to another edition of ESPN News. You didn't want to do it, so I'll say it. Your 24-hour source for sports headlines and highlights, along with Dave Feldman. Actually,
that's right.
I'm Michael Campbell.
He's jinxed us. Dave Feldman has jinxed us. But we are going to not worry about that.
I have a feeling the technical term for what I'm in the control room is the doghouse. But anyway, Michael Chang and Bob Stevens. Stay with
Michael
us.
Chang.
Michael Chang.
Well, we'll have Michael Chang highlights coming up here in a minute. So stay with us.
Call your local cable
You still can't hear me? Ha ha. It's like a Chinese movie to you, huh?
For October. It's going to happen tonight, though, and Al Bernstein is in Las Vegas to bring us up to date on the latest. How you doing there, Al?
I'm good, Dave. How about you?
I'm doing pretty well. Why don't you tell us a little bit about the breakdown on this fight? Only one fighter, Molina, has taken Oscar the distance in this title bite, in this fight. How's this one breaking down?
Hank, thank you very much, and good luck tomorrow.
Thanks, Bill. You too. I got it all nailed. One, two, three. Captain Bodgett, Silver Charm, Touch Gold.
Write those down, folks. We got them from Hank Goldberg.
Is the cool airbox going to force a non-passing event Sunday, much like we witnessed in the Bush clash this past week?
Well, I think guys have had some more time to work on those things.
And Randy Johnson joins us now from the Seattle Mariners. Yeah, let me start over.
I guess this isn't live, is it?
No, it isn't. So if you want to swear, it's okay. This time you can swear. All right.
You're reading off cue cards there?
No, I just got some notes right here.
Oh, okay.
Okay, here we go.
I think so. I think at the beginning of the year, a lot of guys pulled together, stepped up their games just a little bit, and really pulled together as a team. And obviously now with Jacques back, that just helps us that much more. And down the stretch, I think it's going to help our team.
They wanted to get $8.5 million to teams involved in the Bowl Alliance, but fair is fair, and BYU should have been in the Cotton Bowl. I mean, not in the Cotton Bowl, but in the Alliance Bowl. Let's start over.
That's all right.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. We move on to the Rose Bowl. Actually, we're going to Rose Bowl. We got Ohio State, Arizona State as we continue live here on ESPN News. Ohio State, actually, high-octane offense there, but you pick Arizona State.
Yeah, excuse me for that mistake.
No, that's okay. Before.
Well, sure, nobody really uses the word macho anymore, but if you're Hector Macho Camacho or just a real big fan of the Village People, the word is still pretty relevant. Saturday night, the Macho Man will try to retain his IBC middleweight title against 40-year-old Sugar Ray Leonard. After Hector challenged Sugar Ray to the fight back in June. And Hector Macho Camacho joins us now from Atlantic City. And Hector, first tell us about that encounter you had with Leonard, which occurred just after you beat Roberto Duran back in June.
Well, we have another one right now. Don't be comparing me to no Village People, homeboy. You know, I don't like that.
Some people doubt that you can't beat Sugar Ray Leonard. What is your reaction to those beliefs?
Well, I don't think it's some people. I think it's you. I don't like the way you open the whole thing. You go on with the macho, macho this, macho that, and that can't beat Sugar Ray. Not only am I going to beat Sugar Ray, but I'd like to see you sort of beat your butt, too. I like that. Hmm?
You probably would beat my butt. But
and
talk
about it. And I am the greatest fighter of my time, of my era. Mr. Personality, Mr. Excitement. The charismatic character, the bad boy of boxing. When I say bad, I don't mean bad like being bad. I'm talking like bad. I am super bad. I'm going to beat Ray Leonard and very convincingly and a very masterful boxing exhibition.
Okay, Hector Macho Camacho from Atlantic City. Thank you. Good luck on Saturday.
And by the way, I didn't mean to go off on you, you know, but, you know, you put it on yourself.
Yeah, but
I'm not from the, I'm not the Village People.
Yeah, but
no,
they have some good
no,
music. You should
I'm
listen
not the
to
village
some of that.
Well, you're the macho, macho man.
Yeah, that is. Yeah, you know it. You know it.
Okay.
One of their first albums. They're pretty good.
Oh, that ESPN News.
Y'all still trying to rip people off with that old shitty station, aren't you? That's like ESPN2. You only need one ESPN. You don't need more than one. Somebody, you're trying to rip people off buying more cable time. Put something good on ESPN. Get rid of ESPN2. Get rid of ESPN. Nobody buying that crap. Y'all don't have enough good programming on regular ESPN.
This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.
It's Stein-O-Mite.